My name is Matthew Sonntag. I'm an assistant professor in the Department of Chemistry and Biochemistry, technically a physical chemist, and I just finished my first year here at Albright College. So my research has two thrusts. On one hand, I am doing surface enhanced Raman spectroscopy. I'm looking at some fluctuations that appear in the spectra of single molecules. So I have one student working on that, and then I have another student who is making glassy materials and probing their structural properties using Raman spectroscopy. One of our research projects is using the i-Raman Plus to investigate the structural properties of glass.
We're looking at glass because it has a kind of weird network. It's not a set pattern, so you don't really know what bonds are forming where. It's not a crystal structure. So we're using Raman to basically test multiple samples and different compositions of glass, and we're looking for patterns in the way that the bonds form. I'm not a technology person normally. I'm very bad with computers, but I find it very easy to use, and compared to other techniques that you can use, it's a lot easier. There's not a lot of preparation, and it's kind of just put your sample on, set it to the setting you want, and just click a button and you get a spectrum.
One of the benefits of the i-Raman Plus is we have a video microscope that we can attach the i-Raman Plus to. And what this allows us to do is we can use the optical microscope to look at different places on the glass that maybe have interesting structural features. We can take a Raman spectra of that and then move to something that looks a little bit different, take a Raman spectra of that. This really allows us to get some sort of correlation between structural properties and actual chemical properties by looking at the structure we see on the optical microscope and the spectroscopic characteristic that we get from the i-Raman Plus.
I'm looking into Raman spectroscopy actually as an investigative technique. So we're just looking at the different phenomena that occur when you're using Raman spectroscopy at the single molecule level. The software in general is pretty easy to navigate, particularly has helped our research because we can automate it so that we can just take Raman spectra overnight or over the course of a couple hours and I don't have to sit there clicking continuously.
I think that the chemistry and biochemistry program at Albright really wants to integrate the use of instrumentation in the undergraduate laboratory curriculum, and having an i-Raman Plus really helps increase the breadth and depth that we can give our students. The i-Raman Plus is really benefiting my research program in that its ease of use is really helpful. When you're working with undergraduates, you want the instrument to be very user-friendly. We only have a 10-week summer research program, and so with the i-Raman Plus, my students were able to come in, I could teach them everything they needed to know about it on the first day, and on the second day, they were using it for their own research purposes. I would also say that the sensitivity that it has, we're looking at essentially single molecule spectra. It has the ability to get down to those limits, and so those research projects really would not be feasible to do without something like the i-Raman Plus.